Hi, my name is Gus. This is the first video in a learning pathway to teach you how to train an audio classification model and deploy it to your mobile app. Machine learning has shown great results when understanding the environment using vision. But one other very important aspect is sound. Sound can give us a perspective that's not directional like a camera. It doesn't depend on illumination. You can hear sounds the same way no matter if it's day or night, and from a much further distance. Machine learning for audio can be used to understand speech, understand musical instruments, classify events like is it a dog or a cat, which bird is that. You can do pitch detection, even audio and music generation you can do. First, let's understand what is sound. To be simple, sound is what you hear. A better definition is sound is a vibration that propagates as an acoustic wave. Sound has some properties like frequency, amplitude, speed, and direction. When talking about basic usage of machine learning in this domain, frequency and amplitude are the important features. Let's understand waves a little bit better. As you know, we usually don't hear only one thing at a time. There's usually multiple sounds happening at the same time, but usually they have different durations, frequencies, and amplitudes. You usually want to extract information from the dominant one for a given moment. For example, a dog barking or someone speaking something. Let's do a quick math review. This is the sine wave. It has some interesting characteristics. Like it keeps repeating itself, and this is called period. It also has predetermined max and min values, and that's called amplitude. The sine wave has a known equation. As you can see here, A is for amplitude, F is for frequency, T is for time. Okay, why am I telling you that? Because sound waves can often be simplified to sinusoidal waves. Sound is a mixture of their component sine waves. To have a better understanding of sound, you should be able to find all waves that compose it. And that's why it starts to become hard. How do we find the frequencies and amplitude for each wave? But before that, let's understand what is audio. Audio is the electronic representation of sound. Audio frequency ranges from 20 to 20 kHz, which are also the limits of human hearing. You get this data by taking samples or measurements of the air pressure over time. This is usually done by specific hardware like microphone. The number of samples that's taken per second is known as sample rate. When we say that an audio has a 44 kHz sample rate, it means we take 44,000 samples or measurements per second. Of course, the more samples you get, the higher the quality of the sound you can capture. These samples over time result in a waveform. That's where we start. We usually have audio files that will give us these waveforms. But can we apply machine learning to these waveforms? That's where one last concept can help us. And this is a spectrogram. Spectrogram is a visual representation of all the frequencies over time. The y-axis is the frequency in hertz. The x-axis is the time. The color represents the magnitude or amplitude. The brighter, the higher. It's usually in decibels. We can convert a waveform to a spectrogram, which is technically equivalent to an image. Researchers have found that we can effectively apply computer vision techniques to the spectrogram. It turns out that we can classify sound with the same technique used to classify images. With this, a machine learning model can extract the dominant audio per time frame by finding patterns in the spectrogram. Here, you can visualize two different bird songs and how their spectrograms show very different patterns. Now that you know a little bit more about audio and how machine learning can classify it, How can you add audio classification to a mobile app? There are two ways. First, you can use a pre-trained model, or you can train your own model. With a pre-trained model, you can classify more generic audio. A pre-trained model will know it's a bird singing, but it's not specific enough to tell you which one it is. The main advantage of it is that an off-the-shelf model can get you good results without any additional training. On the second case, if you need a model that's not yet available, you can train your own. That's usually the case when your task is very domain-specific, like detecting bird songs. If you want to train your own model, then the steps required are: first, collect and label your training data for your own problem domain. Second, use TF Lite Model Maker to train a custom audio classification model. And finally, deploy the custom model to your mobile app using TF Lite Audio Task Library. Both Model Maker and Audio Task Library are easy to use, and you can train and deploy a custom model in just a few lines of code. However, collecting your training dataset will probably require more work. On this learning pathway, you learn both ways, using a pre-trained model, and later you will learn how to train and deploy your own audio classification model.